So plants around the world are currently doing us a huge service. About 1 in every 4 carbon molecules that we emit into the atmosphere is taken up by plants and stored on land. Without this service, climate change would be moving even faster than it already is. But understanding the reliability and predicting the contribution of this service into the future is difficult. Plant communities are complex systems with many interacting components. The biological richness of places like tropical forests can make scientists sometimes even wonder if there are any common laws that we can rely on. Are there simple concepts that we can use to understand very different forests and predict their behavior into the future? One big clue that there might be is a striking similarity across tropical forests. My colleagues and I became very interested in trying to understand what drives this consistency. To investigate, we went to a tropical forest in the middle of the Panama Canal, where researchers have been working for 30 years to map and repeatedly measure all the trees over 1 centimeter in diameter. We combined this impressive amount of data with a mathematical model to uncover what drives this consistency in their size structure across tropical forests. We found that despite their many differences, tropical forest size structure is governed by a single simple process. When a big tree falls in a forest, this opens up a gap in the canopy. Sunlight rushes through and can hit the forest floor. Small trees can now have the sunlight that they need to grow. They start growing very rapidly until they begin to bump up against one another. At this point, some individuals will overtop the others. They'll be able to continue growing quickly while they'll leave other individuals in the shade growing slowly. This process of moving from fast growth in the sun to slow growth in the shade sets up this characteristic size structure that's common across tropical forests, despite the details of their differences in environments. Now, with this new understanding of tropical forests, we can go on to build better models, we can make more accurate estimates of the carbon storage that's currently in tropical forests, and we can go on to predict, more accurately predict the pace of climate change in the future.